We're going to say that the empirical formula is also known as the simplest formula. Okay? And we're going to say it represents the simplest whole number ratio of moles of each element in a compound. Now, the empirical formula can sometimes be different than the molecular formula. The molecular formula is also known as the actual formula. We're going to say it represents the actual or true whole number ratio of each element in the compound. So let's just see what this means. On beside this, we have a box of C6H12O6. This is the formula for glucose, a simple monosaccharide sugar that our body uses for energy. So we're going to say that's the actual formula of glucose. So that represents the molecular formula of glucose. Now though, we might be asked, what is the empirical formula for glucose? Just think of this in the same way you would with algebra. If your professor says, I give you 2/4, and they want the actual answer would not be 2/4. We can reduce this even further. We can reduce it to 1/2. The 2/4 would be, in a sense, the molecular formula. The 1/2 would be the most reduced form of our answer. That would represent our empirical formula. So, I tell you the molecular formula for glucose is C6H12O6. We're going to say that all those numbers are divisible by 6. So that gives us a new formula, CH2O. That CH2O would represent the empirical formula of glucose. It's the lowest, most reduced form of each of those elements, still keeping them in whole number form.